MLB Network is your exclusive home for postseason baseball. It's game four now of the American League Championship Series between the Houston Astros and the New York Yankees. Hi again, everybody. Matt Vaskirjian welcoming you to our exclusive postseason coverage on MLB Network. With me is Mark DeRosa and Dan Plesac. And Dan, lots of storylines here as we approach the start of Game 4.
Well, I think this series has played out exactly how we expected it to. At 2-1, it's been tightly contested back and forth. We've got two teams worthy of being here, and I think this will go at least 6 games before it's all said and done.
The postseason is officially in full swing. Lineups and first pitch coming up next. Homeside about to take the field. This place is jumping. Here's public address announcer Alex Miniak.
And now, your 2019 New York Yankees.
And briefly here, a glance at the two starters who'll get the ball here in this one. Now here's a look at the Astros starting lineup. What's this club going to need to focus on this evening, Mark?
Well, Matty, you walk into this yard today and it's nothing but a hitter's park. But that can work against you at times. You have to stay within yourself. You can't just be turning and burning on everything. Stay within the game plan and know that a mistake doubles leaving this yard.
Chad Green is the man on the mound for the 4th game of the series. Dan Plesac, what do you got?
Hey, it's hard to have all 4 of your pitches on, but I think if this guy can have 2 or 3 of his 4 pitches and have command of them, he's going to have a really good game.
All right, here's how the Bronx Bombers are going to set up defensively today. And guys, what I want you to focus on today is this is one of the new age teams in the game that really rely on statistics and the numbers. And the numbers tell them that they're a better team defensively, moving guys around and shifting as much as they can.
Now at the plate, George Springer. He'll get us started in this one under the lights. The 1-1 home. Fouled straight back.
Yeah, the rain starting to intensify here. It's coming down a little heavier now. We'll see how much longer the umpires can wait.
Yeah, Matt, right now this doesn't look too good. I wouldn't be surprised if we don't see the umpires come out and bring the ground crew out here. The infield around the mound and around the home plate area is really getting soaking wet. And I can't anticipate this going on very much longer.
So he gets him swinging on a pitcher's pitch. George Springer becomes the first out of the inning. Standing in now, Michael Brantley. And here's a fastball, not close, as he runs it to 2-1 now. Time to take a look at the umpires in this one. Behind the plate is Mike Fillmore.
Hey, you know, D-Roll, Mike Fillmore, he'll give a little bit off the edges, but he gets the respect not only from the pitchers, but from the players because his zone is consistent.
Yeah, as long as he's consistent, Dan, I'm okay with Mike Fillmore's zone. If a pitcher's pounding that zone, he wants to give a little bit off the outer edge, I'm okay with that.
Into the windup, here comes the 2-2 pitch. Popped him up. Torres will wait on it. And there's the second out of the inning.
Batting third, the second baseman, Jose Altuve.
Just getting started here in the Bronx. And a slider's in the dirt as he lays off it for a ball.
lifted down the line in left. And this will wind up a foul ball. The 2-2 one more time. Locks him up for strike three. Astros go down 1-2-3. And now the Yankees will see what they can do. No score. With that, it's time to check out the starting lineup for the hometown Yankees. Thoughts, Dan, who stands out?
Yeah, I'm keeping an eye on DJ LeMahieu. He's such a great talent, the kind of talent that can dominate a game, a perennial all-star, and win some awards. He's one of the best in the game today, and he's always fun to watch.
Brad Peacock will be on the mound for game four. Dan, any thoughts?
Hey, Matty V, we're going to get a chance to look at a guy with a powerhouse slider. This is his bread and butter pitch. Has the other repertoire, but this pitch makes his fastball better. He'll throw a slider to both sides of the plate. He can throw it up, down, in, and out. Extreme command of the slider, and it's one of the reasons why he's one of the top pitchers in the game right now.
Time for a look at the Stros on D. And, guys, the things I want you to focus on today, one of them being this manager loves to shift. He has the pitching staff to trust to be able to manipulate his defense to try and get as many outs and play the numbers as much as he can.
Stepping in, DJ LeMahieu. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. The 1-1. Hit on the ground to third. Bregman fields it cleanly, and there's one down now.
Batting second, the right fielder, Aaron Judge.
Bases are empty, one man out. And that misses off the plate and low, so it's 3-1 now. Brett Gardner is on deck. The 3-1. And he missed with that one. It's ball four. A one-out walk here in the home first.
Batting third, the center fielder.
So a runner at first with one out now. And up next, the left-handed hitting Brett Gardner. Judge stands at first with one out. A line shot to third base. And the runner gets back. No double play.
Batting fourth.
And with two away now, let's give you a look at what's happening in the National League Championship Series, as they've got a good one brewing over there as well. Edwin Encarnacion now. He takes his first cuts in this one with a man at first and two away. One and one, here it is. Maybe too much break on the slider. 2-1. The 2-1 home is taken, ball three.
A lot of times you see guys in the middle of the order get worked away, but not right here. They're keeping it inside on him.
Is that an effort to keep him from getting extended, do you think?
Yeah, I think that's the idea, Matt. But he might spin to win if he starts looking for it in there.
He's set. Here's the 3-1. And this pitch misses for ball four. So that's going to move a runner into scoring position now with two away.
Some guys take a little time to find the zone, but with the second walk of the first inning, it might be a little more than just settling in here. Not sure how long of a leash they'll give him, but they're not going to let him walk the world out there.
Giancarlo Stanton now. Two men are on with two men out. Never tempted to swing at that ball down low. It's ball three.
Wow, this is a pretty good at bat right here. From down in the count 0-2 to work the count back to 3-2. And he's seen a lot of pitches too.
And he misses again. Ball four. And that's back-to-back guys now that have reached base via the base on ball.
That's a big no-no. He obviously had to work carefully with two men on, but he did not want to walk him to load the bases. Now he's really got his work cut out for him. We'll see how he fares here.
Here's the 1-1. Hit high and deep to straightaway right field. Back goes Reddick. Gone! It's a grand slam. So he promptly unloads the bases with that one, his second home run of the series, as they move on top 4-0.
Well, it seems like only a couple of minutes ago that we were ready for a hard-fought game, but things have taken a dramatic turn here early. They jumped all over this guy, including that grand slam, and they might not be done yet.
He's fallen behind now, 3-1. Really starting to pour now, and the forecast is not showing any signs of a break in the weather.
You know, one of the big issues is player safety, and right now this field is getting sloppy wet, Matt, and I don't know how much more rain this field can take.
4 runs here in this half inning. Him here on 3-2 as that pitch misses. It's ball four.
Well, the reason power hitters generally draw more walks than other guys is exactly what we saw right there. Pitchers work around them and nibble the corners a lot more so they don't get burned. He made some good pitches, but he just couldn't get him to chase enough out of the zone.
Here's Didi Gregorius. Head-to-head matchups with Brad Peacock. He's hitless in 3 at-bats. Swing and a ball yanked down the right field line. And this is a fair ball as it'll head for the 314 sign. So now they'll have runners on the corners with 2 away.
He just sports that ball up the wall, and now the question will be, should he have continued on or not? He thought about pushing it, I'm sure, but decided to play it safe. It would have been close, but I think this time he's probably right in staying at first.
Into the box, Gio Urshela. And a pretty good take there on the slider down. It's ball three.
His pitch count is getting up there in the inning now. He needs to get this frame over with sooner than later, so forcing contact and getting the defense involved is probably the best thing he can do.
A good pass at that ball, just a little late, and now the count's full.
All right, 3-2 count with 2 outs. The runner on first will be moving, so we'll see what happens. There are a lot of possible outcomes with this kind of play.
Now the 3-2 pitch, and he takes ball four. So a good job out of the 9 hole in getting on base as we go back to the top of the order.
What's the saying? When you find yourself in a hole, the first thing you should do is stop digging. Well, the guy on the bump obviously hasn't heard that one.
At the plate, DJ LeMahieu, and the Yanks trying to make this first inning even sweeter here. The set and the 1-1 pitch. Fastball not close, and he runs it to 2 balls and a strike.
Right there, it's a temptation pitch. Power hitters like this are looking for pitches that they can drive. So that may have been one where he was trying to get him to chase up above the zone a little bit.
There's a swing, and he sends the ball high in the air into left field. And he will crash into the wall, but hold on to it there for the final out of the inning. One more look at the final out. A teeth rattler if ever there was one. Back with more of Game 4 on MLB Network right after this. Back now for the second inning in the Bronx, and here's Heidi Watney with an update on the weather.
Well, Matt, it doesn't appear that we're going to get much of a break from this rain at all as the game progresses. However, I am also hearing that this rain isn't supposed to intensify too much. The grounds crew will be on standby just in case the umpires do call a delay, but the goal is to get this one in uninterrupted.
Yeah, Heidi, and thanks. Even with all the technology that we have today to be able to forecast the weather accurately, one never knows what Mother Nature has in store. The 3-1 pitch. Popped him up. Gregorius shading to his right. Makes the play, one away.
Batting fifth, the designated hitter, number 44.
Now the 1-1 pitch. Waves and misses for strike number two.
Well, they've really had an answer for keeping him in check in this series. He's offered very little resistance with the bat in his hand so far.
One out, nobody on. Lifted down the line and left. And this will wind up a foul ball. The 1-2. Still a ball and two strikes. Now a swing and a miss. He struck him out, and it's two up, two down to start the second.
Hate to be Captain Obvious here, but he looks great to begin the start. That's already three Ks for him in the first five hitters. It'd be awesome to see him keep up this pace.
So bases are empty here with two gone. And digging into bat next, the Cuban import, Yuli Gurriel. Gurriel behind, a ball and two strikes. Two out, nobody on. On the ground to second for Torres. Reined in. Throw on to first, gets him, and the side is retired. 1-2-3 go the Astros. They're down 4-0. Here's big Aaron Judge. He worked a walk and came around to score in his first trip in this game.
Even though they're up by a boatload early on in this one, you can't get complacent and get lazy. They got to keep the gas pedal down because this team that they're playing can strike and score a lot of runs too.
Just a bit high with the fastball, but didn't get the call.
Yeah, he just isn't that sharp on the mound right now. Had a rough start in the first inning, and now he's falling behind out of the gate here in the second. Some adjustments need to be made, and fast.
Yeah. That one bends into the zone, a strike on the breaking ball. Throw right back at him, and it hit him. Throw to first, but he's safe. And now the stadium's attention turns back to the man on the mound. And time now to see quite where that got him. And it appeared from up here at least, and his actions on the field confirm it. It looked like it got him on his drive leg, which could be problematic, of course, for him. But from the way he's trying to walk it off, I think he's going to try to continue. Here's Brett Gardner now, 0 for 1 for him here in this one. Pitches piling up, 44, and he's not clear of the second yet. And that fastball's too much for him there, 1-2. To 2 balls and 2 strikes now. And this is swung on and missed as Gardner's a strikeout victim, one away.
It's always nice to keep a guy that has good wheels off base, and that's just what they did right there. Big strikeout, keep that guy off the base path.
In now, Edwin Encarnacion. 1-2 now as that one's fouled off.
Get off me, ball. That ball's way too far inside. He's got to step out of the box right now and adjust his batting gloves because he just got stung by a pack of wasps.
And it's fouled away. Ready to deliver the 1-2. A swing and a miss for out number 2, and a ball he had no chance of making contact with. That's back-to-back strikeouts now as they've been unable to advance that leadoff single into scoring position.
Yeah, clearly no problems working out of the stretch right now, Matt. He's taking control this inning after giving up that hit. Now we'll see if he can finish it off strong as well.
The 1-1 home. Drill down the line, and the inning will continue as that's through for a 2-out hit.
Now batting second baseman Weaver Torres.
Into the box now, Torres. Twos all over the place. Two on, two out, and of course here in inning number 2.
Hey, there haven't been a lot of runs scored in this one, but with one swing of the bat, he was able to drive in 4 in his last one. That was a huge grand slam that he hit.
Over at the knees, and that's the second strike. And that one never threatened the zone. It's gone full now to 3-2.
Pretty easy pitch to lay off there, 2-2. Not even close to being in the strike zone. He made it easy for the hitter in that one.
Looking to wiggle out of this. Here it is. Hit hard but foul toward first, so he'll come back and line it up again. Another full count pitch home. Is a called third strike right on the inside corner. Yanks strand a pair. They lead it 4-0. Here's Carlos Correa now. He's the number 7 hitter, but he's leading off the third after the first 6 guys in the lineup have been retired in order.
Yeah, it's been a great start to the guy on the mound. It'll be interesting to see if they can find a way to get to this guy before he really settles in.
Into the windup, here's the 2-1 pitch. 2-2. Out in front as this is skied in the air to straightaway left. There to take it is Gregorius for the first out.
Batting it, the right fielder, shot ready.
So the bases are empty with one man gone. And that brings up the former Gold Glover Josh Reddick. The 1-1 is laid off for ball two. Now the 2-1 pitch. Count even at 2-2. Here's one that misses inside, and the count's run full now, 3-2.
One of the things you want to do with a starter, get that pitch count up. Here's another productive at bat as this count now gets to 3 balls and 2 strikes.
Popped up. Sanchez is there and he makes the catch for the second out.
Batting ninth, the catcher, number 28, Robinson Chirinos.
Stepping into the box, Robinson Chirinos. And then it seems like this starter is just dominating the game right now. Feels like we're seeing a lot of three up, three down innings.
No doubt about that, Matt. Hey, I've enjoyed watching him go about his business, but I'm also interested to see if this offense can figure out a way to get a couple of cracks in his armor before it gets too late.
Yeah, that remains to be seen. Now the 1-1 pitch. Misses, ball two. Double barreled action in the Yankee bullpen now. A lefty and a right-hander start to get loose. Into the windup, here's the 2-1 pitch. On, he jumps on this one. It's high and deep to center. Gardner going back, still going back. So a solo shot here to left center field, his second home run of the series. As they get on the board, it's 4-1 now.
Only the first hit of the night, but it was a big one. He absolutely punished that mistake, and you have to wonder if that will open the floodgates a little.
CC Sabathia is going to come on to pitch here, and in just the third inning, you have to think he'll be asked to eat some innings.
Number 52.
Stepping in now, George Springer. Ripped on the ground to first. And that finds its way through for a base hit.
Boy, so frustrating as a pitcher. You make a quality pitch on the inside half of the plate right there. Try to bust him in, D-Row, and he fights it off the other way.
Yeah, you tip your hat to the pitcher right there. He executed his pitch, but nice job by the offensive player. Fighting. It doesn't matter what it looks like. A knock's a knock.
Standing in now, Michael Brantley. 1-2 now. And he turns on this one and yanks it foul and back out of play. High in the air and drifting out to shallow center. Gardner is there, makes the catch, and that'll retire the side. Astros claw back a bit on this solo home run. Bottom of the third coming up. The Yankees 4 and the Astros 1. Welcome back to the Bronx as we check in with Heidi.
Thanks, Matt. I talked with the Yankees manager Aaron Boone during the break about the team's offensive performance so far, and flat out, he was very pleased with the quality of their at-bats. They've earned 5 walks in the game, and he said that's not only leading to a lot of run-scoring opportunities, but it's also forcing the pitching on the other side to work a lot harder and throw more pitches than they want to.
All right, thanks, Heidi. Digging in now for the Yankees, Gary Sanchez. He drew a walk his first time up.
One of the keys to securing a win, they want to keep the pressure on and try to build that lead as much as they can moving into the later innings.
The 2-1 home is looked at for ball three. Now the Astros have somebody up in the bullpen as a right-hander has started to warm up out there. Hit hard, but right into the shift. And that's out number one.
Now batting, shortstop, Didi Gregorius.
Now at the plate, Didi Gregorius, one for one after a single his first time up. 4-1's our score here in inning number three. Too high that time, and it's 3-1. Lifted the other way down the left field line, and this will wind up a foul ball. And now a slider in there for a called third strike, and there are two gone now.
Beautiful backdoor slider for the punch out right there, guys. When it's tight like this one was, it looks like a fastball off the plate, then darts back at the corner at the last second. Locked them up completely with that one.
Into the box now, Gio Urshela lofted in the air out toward right center. Reddick has a read on it, and the inning is over. 1-2-3 go the Bombers as they hold on to a 4-1 lead. Here's the second baseman, Jose Altuve, comes into this at bat 0-1 in the ballgame.
Hey, we're still in the early stages in this one. They're only down by a couple of runs, but it's really key for this leadoff guy to try to get on and get a big inning started.
And he lays off there, ball four. So the leadoff man is on here to begin stanza number four.
You know, it takes a lot of discipline to watch a pitch like that go by, but on a 3-1 count, he had the luxury of being a little bit more selective up there. Good take, and a walk is the result.
Riding in once again, Alex Bregman. Flied out in his first at-bat, so make him 0-1 so far.
Almost, Matty. Almost went deep his last AB. Certainly just missed it. With this guy's big power, he's feeling pretty good at the dish. Look for him to try and get on something and drive it out of the yard this AB.
The 1-2. Tried to hold up there. Appeal down to first and no swing. It's ball two. Altuve gets his lead at first. Nobody out. And he'll step off the rubber and go to first. Back in standing. And Sabathia misses here. It runs full now. 3-2. Working for the punch out and the offering. Popped him up. Torres is under it. He's got it one away.
Now batting, number 44.
Digging in to try it again, number 44. He's 0-1 thus far. 4-1 our score as we play inning number four. Now he gets the ground ball to first. This might be two. There's one on to first as they get the double play to get him out of the inning. Nothing across here this half of the inning. On now to the bottom half of inning number four. The Yankees lead this one 4-1. Josh James please. Answers the call now, from the pen here in the fourth as they didn't get the outing they were hoping for from their starter. So it's back to the top of the order now, and that'll bring in DJ LeMahieu. A swing and a shot hit down the corner. Nearly a big fly to start the inning. Instead, a foul ball. The 1-2 is looked at for ball number two.
Well, one thing about him, he's an absolute grinder at the plate. You can pretty much count on him battling at the plate every chance he gets.
And a good bite to that slider as he swings through it for the first out of the inning. And there are the final numbers for the Astros starting pitcher.
Right fielder,
clearly not the postseason outing he had envisioned.
One of the tough things to do when you're trying to have a good pitching performance is keep the ball in the ballpark. He was filling up the strike zone, but he did allow two home runs.
So one away here with the bases empty, and that'll bring up the former American League Rookie of the Year, Big Aaron Judge. The 1-2. It is a fastball in off the plate for a ball.
That's the kind of pitch that reminds me of many reasons why I wasn't a very good hitter. This thing was inside and coming in hot, and he just gave a stone cold take. I'm bailing out of the way if I'm in the box, no doubt about it.
And a half-hearted attempt that time, but they'll say he broke the plane, and that's out number two.
Fooled him just enough with that pitch to get him to go around, according to the umpire. Sometimes it can be really tough for these big, strong guys because once they're committed to swinging, it's hard for them to slow their swings down, and that appeared to be the case there.
Into the box, Brett Gardner. And this is taken low for ball four, and they'll have themselves a two-out base runner here after all.
Man, you hate to give up a two-out walk to anybody, but especially to a speed demon like him. Good chance he's running here, and good luck trying to stop him.
So a runner at first here with two gone in the inning, and that'll bring up the power bat of Edwin Encarnacion. Now a throw over to first, runner back safely. Four runs, four hits, and no errors for the Yankees so far.
Run.
And there he goes toward second. In there, now the throw. And in fact, there will be no throw as he loses the handle there on the transfer. Now a fastball awfully close, but he doesn't get the call. It's 2-2 now. Got him looking, and that ends the inning. One left for the Yankees, but they lead it 4-1. Welcome back. Heidi Watney standing by as we get set for the top of the fifth.
Thanks, Matt. I talked with Astros manager A.J. Hinch between innings, specifically about his club's offense to this point. And he told me he's pretty unhappy with their discipline at the plate in this one. He said their pitch selection has been the main reason for their struggles today, as far too often they've been swinging at pitches outside the strike zone. That's leading to a lot of soft contact and easy outs. So the focus going forward is on shrinking the zone and forcing the opposing pitching to throw more strikes.
Thank you, Heidi. Now the Cuban import Yuli Gurriel, and to start out the inning, it looks like they've decided to stick with the same reliever out there, Dan.
They have, Matt. I think the way he pitched the last inning kind of inspired that, but it's not uncommon for relief pitchers to have troubles after they sit and watch their guys swing the bat a bit. We'll see if he stays as sharp as he was before.
Sent on the ground out to second. Torres picks it up. And the fifth inning will start with a ground out, one away.
The batter, number one, shortstop Carlos Correa.
So the base is empty here with one away. And the former number one overall pick in American League Rookie of the Year, Carlos Correa, bats next. And this is swung on and missed, so it's two up, two down to start the fifth.
Well, I'm glad we get another look at that beauty of a pitch right there. You can't spot a sinker in a better location, because even if you do get the bat on the ball, there's not a whole lot you could do with that. Textbook sinker.
Stepping in now, Josh Reddick. Popped up. LeMahieu over to his right. And that retires the side. Astros go down 1-2-3. And this is still a 4-1 ball game. Ready once again, Giancarlo Stanton. Last time through was a base hit. The 1-1 is taken for ball two. And a big swing and a miss here, two strikes. Here's one that misses inside, and the count's run full now, 3-2. Swing and a miss, and he'll start the fifth the same way he ended the fourth, with a punch out, one away.
Well, we'll see a lot of these power arms coming out of the bullpen in these days, but it doesn't make it any less impressive to me. I love watching guys come in and blow smoke right by guys.
In now, Torres. Change up. Good pitch there. 1-2.
All right, let's go.
Takes this the other way to right. But this will not get out there deep enough, as it's run down by the right fielder in the alley for the second out.
Well, we've mentioned the conditions aren't ideal with the rain coming down, and that can make every play a little bit of an adventure. You really have to concentrate, and he did there to haul it down.
So bases are empty here with two gone, and the next to bat, the Dominican-born catcher, Gary Sanchez. Now the 3-2 pitch. Hit sharply toward the right side. That gets down, and he's got himself a base hit. So he wins the full count battle and finds a way to extend the inning.
Well, now you see how difficult it is to be a catcher. This ball is really smoke, gets all the way to the wall, D-Row, but he just doesn't have the foot speed to turn this into an extra base hit.
Yeah, his calling card is definitely not his ability to run the bases. It's for offense and massaging a pitching staff.
Standing in now, Didi Gregorius. Changeup, called a strike, and he comes back even at 2-2. Swung on and missed, and that's the final out of the inning. Yanks leave one as they hold on to a 4-1 lead. Corey Guerin takes over to start the sixth inning on the mound.
Number 35, Corey Guerin.
Robinson Chirinos will stride in again, and before he takes his cuts here, let's flash you back to the third inning. This was just a solo shot, but it definitely helped get this offense going. The 2-2 doesn't get the zone, count full now.
It'd be great right here if he was able to work himself on base. You got the leadoff hitter on deck, and you know the middle of the order is coming up right behind him.
Ready now with the payoff pitch. Tough pitch to lay off, but he did, and it's ball four, so the leadoff hitter is aboard to start the sixth.
The center fielder, number four, George.
Here's George Springer. It was a single for him in his last at-bat. The 1-1.
That's a strike.
Misses for the second ball.
You can't allow this offense to get going right here. Leadoff man on doesn't kill us. Let's try and roll a double play right here. Let's execute a good pitch down and away. See if we can get a ground ball and rely on your defense a little bit.
Here's the 2-1. And this is on the inside edge, perhaps off the inside edge, but it's a called strike. 2-2 now. Hoping to send him packing. Pitch on its way. Back up the middle. That gets through, and he'll reach base again on his second base hit of the game.
Hey, guys, he's not known for being a singles hitter right here, but that's his second knock in the game.
And I'm sure he'll take him, but the guys on the other side of the scorecard might be thinking we really avoided a worse fate. Into the box, Michael Brantley. Slider clocked in the mid-80s there. It's a ball and two strikes. Bounced weakly near the plate. That winds up foul. Another 1-2 delivery. In the dirt here. And a nice job to keep the runners at bay as the count moves to 2-2. Chirinos over at second. Springer on at first with nobody out. Still even at 2-2. Hit on the ground down the first baseline, but a foul ball as it holds it 2-2. Woo! Just low that time with the heavy sinker as it's ruled ball three.
Hey, this has been an epic at bat right here. I don't blame the pitcher for a little nibbling right there. Maybe get a swing and a miss. He didn't bite on that one, so now we go full count.
Drive, base hit into the left center field gap. And that'll score the runner from second as the lead is cut to 4-2 now.
Boy, what a battle there, D-Ro. Several pitch at bat right there. He threw everything but the kitchen sink, and he was still able to get an RBI base hit.
And, Dan, I can't tell you, the longer the ABs go, usually, I'll tell you, you get in that swing mode where if he throws the rosin bag, you're pulling the trigger on it. Wait for him to settle in his zone and not come outside of it and end up getting a knock.
Ground ball to second. This could be two. To second for one. On to first, but not in time as he beats it out. So they avoid what could have been a costly double play there.
Yeah, Matt, credit the batter for busting out of the box and hustling down the line instead of getting mad at himself for rolling over on a ground ball. It's little things like that that can change the whole game.
Stepping in now, Alex Bregman. The ball and two strikes.
With two strikes and the runners at the corners, this is a big pitch coming up. Got to execute to hope to either get a strikeout or a double play ball to help you get out of this thing.
Come on, New York.
Quick. lays off the 1-2 changeup, and he's worked it back to 2-2. Swing and a miss, and they'll dodge a major bullet that time. Two away.
Now batting. Number 44.
Now to the plate, number 44. And they're runners at the corners now. Two runs, four hits. No errors in the ballgame for the Astros to this point. Changeup just off the black, and it's 2-1. Ready to deal. Here's the 2-1. Now he goes the other way, and he got a lot of it high and deep to left center field. Gone! So a three-run shot to left center, his first homer so far in the series, as they will take the lead here. It's now a 5-4 ball game.
Well, people always wonder why some players make so much money, and there's your answer. The great ones find a way to rise to the occasion in the postseason, and he did right there.
Into the box now, Yuli Gurriel. Breaking ball that time that misses out of the zone. His prior history versus this arm, just a couple of matchups, no hits in two at-bats. The 3-1. Tried to crush that ball, and now perhaps needs to shorten up with two strikes. Hits are even right now at five aside. And this is pulled foul as he was way out in front there. He loses him on ball four.
Right about now, the manager's questioning his decision to bring this guy in. If you can't trust a reliever to throw strikes, you can't trust him at all. We'll see if he comes to get him sooner than later.
At the plate, Carlos Correa. He looked to bounce back after striking out his last time up.
Sometimes you just got to tip your cap to the guy on the mound. He's getting paid to try and get you out as well. Anytime it gets up there, north of 7-8 pitch ABs, sometimes it just comes down to pure execution. Let's see if he makes the adjustment right here.
The 1-1 pitch. And whoa, this is off the third base bag. And there's his first base hit in this one. And he will reach it first, but it's very possible that he might have had two bases there had that ball
now
not hit the bag.
Right fielder.
Boy, that's not a bad pitch right there. That's a pretty good sinker. He just happens to hook that one right into left field for a base hit.
Yeah, he got the bat head out right there, Dan, and was able to get that one to left field.
Tommy Kahnle trots in from the bullpen here as he inherits a tough spot with two on and two away. Standing in now, Josh Reddick. Good change of speeds, but he lays off 2-1.
Boy, he better get it back together here quick because he's got two guys on already. He's starting to lose location of that strike zone. He's got to throw a strike right here.
Go, 2-1 pitch is a slider taken for a cold strike two. And he strikes him out here, so he's able to stop the bleeding a bit as the side is retired. But four runs score in the inning, three coming right here on the three-run home run. Bottom of the sixth coming up. Houston's out in front, 5-4. Ready now, Gio Urshela. He flew out in his last at-bat. Now the 1-1 pitch is in there for the second strike.
Bobby Cox always used to say, I'm going to put you in positions to be successful. Well, against a modern-day bullpen, easier said than done. These guys are throwing flames from all arm angles.
The 2-2. Takes this the other way to right. Reddick is there, one away.
Boy, talk about hitting into some rough luck. That was an absolute bullet to the outfield that gets caught. And he would have represented a tying run.
In now, DJ LeMahieu. Line to the right side. And that'll make him 1-for-4 in this one.
You think there's any justice in the game? Watch those two at bats. Both of them now hit on the absolute screws. One's right at one guy, and then one's a single. Go figure.
In now, Aaron Judge. He was sent packing on strikes in his last trip.
Yeah, Matty, and hopefully he got it out of his system. Especially now, he's got to bear down. He gets the two strikes in this spot, has to put the ball in play.
Both teams with six hits so far. Now a fastball that just misses here as the count moves to 2-1. Looked like he tried to pull it there, but he swings right through the fastball. Here's the 2-2. Popped him up. Bregman shading to his right. He hauls it in without any trouble, and there are two away.
The batter, the center fielder, Gardner.
Ready for another chance, Brett Gardner. No hits in two trips to the plate for him in the ball game. He's ready with the 2-2 pitch. And it looked like the fastball got away from him there.
Full count with two outs now, so if he could put the ball in the gap somewhere, he could have a good shot of driving in a run because the runner at first will be in motion.
Swing and a miss. Blew the fastball right by him, and the inning is over. One left for the Yankees, and the deficit holds at 5-4. Back here in the Bronx, game four is off to the seventh inning now, but before we get it started, let's check out our game summary to this point. Settling in now, Robinson Chirinos. He homered back in the third inning in this one. Set and the 3-1 pitch, and a good take there as they'll have a leadoff man aboard to start the seventh. It's ball four.
Boy, oh boy, that's a tough one for the pitcher. He's definitely wondering where the heck was that pitch. I think he called it high, but our strike zone says otherwise.
So a runner at first now with nobody out, and former World Series MVP George Springer bats next. Crowd gets up for the 3-2. Too close for comfort, and he did a good job just to make contact. Once again, a 3-2. Fastball called, strike three, and there's the first out of the inning.
The left fielder, number 23, Michael.
Coming to the plate now, Michael Brantley. Lifetime versus this pitcher. He's 1-for-3. Runner goes for second. High in the air down the right field line. But this is just going to wind up being a foul ball. Chirinos, the runner at first with one gone in the inning. And he lays off a pitch off the plate and high, 3-2.
We could see the runner in motion here on a 3-2 count with one out. There's a pretty good chance he's going to get a pitch to swing at, and if not, it's ball four anyways.
Left side, but well fouled. Another full count pitch home. Hit hard on the ground to second. Torres has it. One there. Relay to first in time. And just Ladies like that, this side is retired. Astros are down quietly. They hold on to a 5-4 lead.
Your attention, please.
Now, good pitcher coming on now as we'll get a look at the side armor, Joe Smith.
Joe Smith.
Digging in now, Edwin Encarnacion. It's been an 0-for-2 effort for him to this point.
This thing's far from over, even though we're moving into the back end of this game. Only down by one. All they need to do is get this leadoff guy, and they're an extra base hit away from tying this thing up.
Now the 2-1 pitch. Takes a pass and misses. That's strike two. Some action out in the bullpen. Couple of right-handers starting to loosen up. Here now the 2-2 is looked at and the count moves full. Don't go too far. The dangerous Giancarlo Stanton gets his shot next. Now the 3-2 pitch. Still hanging with him. Another good swing to keep it going. Line drive snagged on a short hop. Throws in time, and that's out number one.
Now batting, the left fielder, Giancarlo Stanton.
Into the box now, Giancarlo Stanton. Bases are empty, one man out. Looking for the strikeout. Here's the 1-2. Looked like the fastball got away from him there. It's ball two. Oh, forget about this one. Bob Bowie. And as Yankees fans here on television quite frequently, see ya! It's a solo blast off the bat of Giancarlo Stanton. His second home run of the series as we are all tied at 5. That home run is definitely worth giving the show track treatment to. And as we look at it, not only an impressive distance shot, but the 110 miles an hour exit velocity is nothing to scoff at either. That's a big boy home run. Into the box, Torres. Oh, there it goes. In the air to left center, and you can forget about this one. Back-to-back home runs. So a solo shot here to left center field, his second of the game, and this one gives him the lead at 6-5. Watching an impressive power display today. With that one, these two teams have now hit a combined 5 homers in this game.
Matty V, this is turning into Home Run Derby Part 2. D-Row, five bombs already in this one.
Yeah, there's a fight at the bat rack for both teams right here. A lot of mislocations right out over the heart of the plate, and neither side is missing.
Hector Rondon takes the call from the pen as he'll try to get the final two outs of this seventh frame. Stepping in now, Gary Sanchez. Hard hit to first. And a sliding attempt at first, but this sneaks by him, a base hit.
Adapt and persevere. That's what I always said on the offensive side. Down in the count right there. Batter hits a ground ball the other way. He's able to fight off the tough count and get himself a base hit.
Into the box now, Didi Gregorius. Now a changeup, but it misses just a little below the zone. Sanchez leads off first with one away. Now a swing and he gets him to pop it up. Will this be a big out of the bullpen? Bregman backs up and takes care of it. Two away.
The batter, the third baseman, Gio Urshela.
That'll bring in Giovanni Urshela. He lined out in his last trip, so looking for better fortunes here.
Yeah, Matty, but as he walks to the plate right here, he feels good building off that last AB. He hit that ball on the screws.
And he takes ball two, and it's 2-1. He's fallen behind now, 3-1. A runner on first with two away. And he goes with the pitch here and drives it the other way to deep right. And the Bombers have it going here as this is also good for extra bases. The relay, not in time, and he's in there with a double.
That was a great job of driving that ball, extending his arms very well, was able to get it over the right fielder's head, one hopping it off the wall for an easy double. That's one of those solid hits that you don't even feel coming off the bat.
Back to the top of the lineup, stepping in, DJ LeMahieu. He steps in off a base hit in his last at-bat.
Yeah, and just another simple single to the outfield would be a big one right here. Don't try and do too much. You know there's a potential base open right there. Maybe sit off speed.
Looking to keep this a one-run game, the pitch. 2-1. Hit the other way out toward right field. Reddick has a read on it, and the inning is over. So two runs come across here, both coming via the solo home run. We'll look ahead to inning number 8 now. The Yankees are out in front, 6-5. Adam Ottavino has been summoned from the bullpen as he'll do so to start the 8th.
Number 0, Adam.
So stepping in, Jose Altuve. He reached on a fielder's choice previously. The 1-1 sinks below the knees, taken for a ball. As we near the end of this one, it's clear the long ball has played a big role in today's outcome. Dan, D-Row, what are your final thoughts on what we've seen?
Yeah, just non-competitive pitches in some big situations, Dan, and the offense took full advantage. Yeah,
you know, D-Row, one of the things about pitching is you want to have location, and it was obvious in this one today that the pitchers weren't on point, and what happens when that happens? Hitters make you pay, and the long ball was a big part of this one here.
And he wasn't going to hit that one with an or the strikeout, and there's one gone. Eighth inning from Yankee Stadium. Yankees on top in this one at home as you get a look at the line score.
Redhead.
And that'll bring up the former first rounder Alex Bregman. His head-to-head numbers against Adam Ottavino. Not a big sample size, 0 for 1. He's set, and the 2-1 pitch fouled away. One out, nobody on. Another 2-2 offering, ripped down the first baseline, and he'll step on first himself for the out.
And hey, if the first baseman is playing straight up there, that's probably a double down the line, but in order to prevent that late in the game, they had him guarding the line, and it obviously worked out perfectly.
In now, number 44, line drive to left. Well, this is right to him in left as he hardly has to move as he handles it for the final out. Pretty painless half of the inning, all told. Home half of the eighth straight ahead. It's the Yankees 6 and the Astros 5.
Ladies,
Chris Devinsky is on the pitch out of the bullpen in the bottom half of the eighth.
For Houston, number 47, Chris Devinsky.
Digging in, Aaron Judge. He got under one and popped out his last time up.
Yeah, I don't mind him trying to drive the ball in the air, but he can't collapse the backside, and that's exactly what he did in his last at bat. Look for him to stay a little taller and keep that upper half a little bit more over him.
Lays off, 2-2 now. And a changeup swung on and missed for the first out.
People always talk about how important getting the leadoff men on base is,
and
it's true. So in the eighth inning of a one-run game, that's a really nice job of attacking a hitter and sending him packing.
Standing in, Brett Gardner, head-to-head against Chris Devinsky. He's gone 2 for 5. He's taken him deep once. Ready with the 1-1. A good action on the two seamer there, and it's 1-2.
He's staring a hat trick in the face right now after that swing. He has just got to find a way to zone up a little bit more. You cannot expect to make solid contact chasing stuff outside the zone.
The 1-2. Early swing there as he pulls it foul to the right side. Bases are empty, one man out. Struck him out. Struck him out again, I should say. His third punch out of the game. What's your take on all the strikeouts we see in the game today, Dan? That was his third tonight, and it seems we're seeing that a lot more these days.
Yeah, Matt, there's been a real change in philosophy as far as hitting in baseball today. A lot of guys think now that an out is an out, a strikeout is just as good as a regular out, but we're seeing strikeouts at an alarming rate in baseball right now.
Standing in now, Edwin Encarnacion. High in the air and deep to left center field. Springer looking up. Out of here, into the visitor's bullpen. So a solo home run for Edwin Encarnacion. His third home run of this series, and they take a 7-5 lead. Well, that's the sixth home run we've watched leave the yard in this one. Guys, what do you think's behind the hitting we've seen here today?
Yeah, hey, Matty V, this big ballpark in the Bronx has that short porch in right field, D-Roll. But you can hit the ball out of it just about any part of this ballpark.
Yeah, this place plays sneaky small. I know it's got big gaps, but right field is so juicy.
And we'll have to leave it there as this is strike three, and that will retire the side. Yankees do get one on the solo homer. Last chance coming up for the Astros. It's now 7-5. Your oldest Chapman lead. Comes on from now the pen, hoping to finish this one off here in the top of the ninth. So striding in, Yuli Gurriel. Lifetime line against Chapman. He's 2-for-4. Now the 1-1 pitch is in off the plate. Chapman has a good reputation for preventing the long ball. One swing can change the complexion of the ball game when you're coming in late, but he rarely lets that happen. Part of what makes him as effective as he is. Three and one now.
Hey, leading off an inning in this situation, three balls on you. You have to know that a solo shot's not tying this game up. You have to find a way to get on base any way possible.
Lofted in the air out toward right center. Torres calls for it. He's got it one away.
Boy, he showed some pretty good range heading pretty deep into the outfield to bring that one down. Thought the outfielder might call him off, but he clearly had it under control.
Into the box, Carlos Correa. And he misses with that one down and in. It's a full count now, 3-2. And a left-handed batter waiting on deck, though there's a good shot he might get pulled back. Now the 3-2 pitch. And he lost him here on 3-2 as that pitch misses. It's ball four.
Up next for the Astros, the right fielder.
So a runner at first now with one away, and that brings up the former Gold Glover Josh Reddick. Here's the 1-1, and he fouls this one off. Reddick waiting, and now the pitch. And a fastball swung on and missed as they set him down for the second time here tonight. Got him with a good high fastball there. Danny, we see a lot of that pitch in strikeout situations these days. What makes it so effective?
I think, Matt, what makes it such a tough pitch is you're changing eye levels. That fastball up looks so enticing to hit that you think you see that ball as a hitter. You think it can drive it, but it's really hard to get on top of that good, high, hard fastball.
Good pitch as this is swung on and missed, and now they're down to perhaps their final strike of the evening. Now the Yankee Stadium crowd, 52,000 plus on their feet. And this one's in the dirt. And it's not in time as he's in well ahead of the throw. And he'll make it into scoring position here with two away as that'll be scored a wild pitch.
And as a closer, a wild pitch is the last thing you want to do. His job was to finish this thing off, and he just made his job a lot more difficult. We'll see if he can get dialed in again here on the next pitch.
Correa at second with two down. Last strike now for Houston. Not where he wanted that fastball to be, and it's 3-2 now.
Time to narrow your focus up there at the plate. In a one-run game, he doesn't want to walk you, so there's a good chance he's going to get something to handle right here.
has them down to their final strike. Here it comes. Now a swing and a ground ball. This should do it. Torres brings it in. Throw on to first, and the Yankees have battled back to knock this series up at two games apiece as this ball game is over.
Man, facing Chapman is not for the faint of heart as he unleashes fireball after fireball. Gets the final out here and another save. What a weapon Chapman is.
Before we take our leave, time for a look at our final line score here in what turned out to be a close two-run victory. And there's no better time of year to come up big for your team than in the postseason. And that's exactly what this man did. He's our Topps player of the game.
And obviously every game is so important in the postseason. So when you come to play like he did and make a big difference for your team, it's something that won't be forgotten.
Seven-5 tonight's final. New York have evened up this league championship series at two games apiece. Tommy Kahnle is the winning pitcher of record. So that's a wrap for us here tonight. For my partners in the booth, Mark DeRozan, Dan Plesac, and Heidi Watney on the field, this is Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB Network. Have a good night, everybody.